Hey guys, this is Austin, and today I'm here with a tutorial on how to build a gaming computer. This is based on my $600 mini ITX PC inside the Bitphoenix Prodigy, however most of this applies to building any computer. If you're interested in learning what parts I used, feel free to check out my build guides. Before we begin, you should find a workspace on tile or wood floors to help prevent static electricity from building up. Touching the case is a great idea to discharge any static. As far as tools go, all you really need is a Phillips screwdriver. Building a PC is very simple, and most of the time you can even use thumb screws. First step is to prepare the case, which here is a Bitphoenix Prodigy. On the right side, you'll see the power and reset buttons, headphone and microphone jacks, along with a pair of USB 3.0 ports. Around back is a 120mm fan, your motherboard tray, slots where the graphics card will reside, and the power supply. Start by removing the four thumb screws on the back. You'll find one top and bottom on the left side, one on the bottom right, and finally one on the top right. Now remove the left side panel by pulling it back and then off, then set it aside for later. Then do the same for the right side panel to free up some room to work on the case. Inside you'll see a box which contains screws, so set that aside for now. Before working in the case, we need to remove the center drive cage by pressing on the tab so we have room to install the graphics card. Set the case aside for a minute and grab the motherboard. Inside the box you'll find a pair of SATA cables for connecting a hard drive or optical drive, the I/O shield for mounting the motherboard, a driver's DVD and case badge, and the manual which will be helpful in a few minutes. The motherboard itself is sensitive to static and is wrapped in an anti-static bag. Gently pull it out by handling it by the plastic components and then set it down on the box the motherboard comes in. This is how we'll be working on it until it's installed in the case. Before we get to work, let me take a minute and go over a few important things to pay attention to. Around back, you'll find all of your ports including USB, Ethernet, and audio out which will be sticking out the back of the case when we're done. You'll see a pair of long blue connectors which is where your RAM will be installed. On one side, you'll be able to press the white clips back so that we are all ready to install the memory. The bottom of the board is where you'll find the long, darker blue connector. This is PCI Express, which is what we'll be using to connect the graphics card in a few minutes. Beside the heatsink with the ASUS logo are 6 SATA ports. These can be used for many things, but for this build we're just going to be using a single port for the hard drive. One thing to keep in mind is that the white ports are going to be what you'll use if you have an SSD, as they're faster than the blue ports. In the center of the board is where the CPU is installed, and it should have a plastic cover protecting the socket for now. Now it's time to open up the processor, in this case a Core i3. Inside the box, you'll find the heatsink and fan, which has pre-applied thermal paste on the bottom. Be sure not to touch this. There's also a bit of info on the CPU, as well as a Core i3 case badge if you want to use it. The CPU itself is inside the cardboard and protected inside a bit of plastic. Before removing it, keep in mind that there are tiny gold pins on the bottom, and you do not want to touch these at all. Come over to the motherboard and remove the cover by pulling on the tab labeled Remove. Then push the arm to the side to get access to the socket. Grab the CPU by the edges and just rest it into the socket. Don't press it in at all, it should fit by itself. There's a small golden arrow on the edge which will make sure you align it properly. Set the cover back down and push the arm down to hold it into place. You'll have to put a lot of pressure on it, but don't worry, this is normal. Time to install the heatsink. Just align the four pegs over the holes in the motherboard and press each down until they click. Once you're done, you can now pick up the motherboard by the heatsink without any worries. Installing your RAM is up next. You'll find a notch in the memory as well as in the slot on the motherboard so it only goes in one way. Line it up with a thumb on each corner and press firmly until it clicks into place. Grab the second DIMM, line it up, and install it the same way. Super easy stuff. Now it's time to install the assembled motherboard into the case. The Prodigy mounts it lying flat on top of the four built-in standoffs. First, grab your I/O shield that came with the motherboard and pop it into the back panel. Press firmly until it snaps into place, and don't worry, you'll probably need a minute to get it popped in correctly. Handling the motherboard by the heatsink, carefully align it over the four standoffs against the back of the I/O shield. Gently shift the motherboard back so that all of the ports are clear. Make sure that the little metal pins are touching and that each and every port is lined up. Now grab the box of hardware we pulled out of the case earlier and you'll see a bag of screws. Open it up and find four of the smaller screws. If you aren't sure which to use, the Prodigy manual shows the exact design. Now screw the motherboard into place. The best way to do it is to start with one corner and tighten it moderately but not all the way, and then go to the opposite corner and do the same, while double checking that it's still in the correct spot and everything is visible out the I/O shield. Then go back and screw the last two screws into place. Once you're done and everything looks good, tighten each screw to make sure everything is fully in place. Nicely done, you've got everything assembled on the motherboard and it's securely installed in the case. That's it for part 1 of this tutorial. If you enjoyed, don't forget to hit up that like button and check out part 2. Anyway guys, I'll catch you in the next one.